Hi everyone, good to see you. I'm Julie Lindsay and I'm a global collaborator. What I want to share today is on the edge of learning in schools. And it shouldn't be. Global collaboration. For the past 20 years, I have explored how to connect people with the world for global collaboration. My current PhD research examines online global collaborative educators. And I want to share with you some examples of people who are doing this, who are learning on the edge. Meet Lauren. Lauren is a typical high school student from the USA. She joined one of my global collaborative projects last year. She came in as a team leader. She led about 10 students from three different countries. These students worked together virtually, of course, to co-create some research around a particular theme. They then created their own personal piece of multimedia. Lauren designed hers so that part of it was an outsourced clip from another student. Her video was deemed to be the best video for the project. It built such confidence in her that we asked her to present at an international educator conference and speak about her global learning opportunities. Meet Anne. Anne is my colleague in Australia. Anne lives in Victoria. She lives on a farm. She's married to a dairy farmer. She says, "The world is my classroom." Anne has taken students outside of Australia. She's taken them to the Middle East, to India. But more importantly, Anne builds these learning environments within her school across the curriculum for students to learn with others. So even though Anne is in an isolated part of the world, she can still connect with the world. Meet Tracy. Well, actually, this is not Tracy. This is one of Tracy's students. Tracy is an educator in Colorado. She's a STEM specialist. Now, Tracy joined her school with a school in Canada and with an orphanage in Uganda. And together, they went on this STEM global collaboration to solve a problem. The problem was that students in Uganda don't have electricity. They couldn't study at night. So as a STEM project, they designed this light. That's what the boy's holding up there. It's this USB-powered light that can be charged in their local library and provides light in the evenings. But the really exciting thing is this can be 3D printed. So my research is showing that global connections build empathy. Now, this means being able to understand and share the feelings of others. Now, this is really the crux of what I'm talking about, that empathy that leads to trust, that leads to working relationships, like Lauren when she led a global team. Anne says, "I think when we collaborate globally, we learn just as much about those other people as we do about ourselves." So it's about our personal identity as well, who we are in terms of and how we then connect with others. Another outcome of taking learning local to global is being able to work with real people, being able to be part of those diverse conversations and situations, and technology allows us to do this. My colleague in the States, Craig Union, completed his PhD around online global collaborative projects and how the impact on students with their ethnocentricity, and he found that students had less ethnocentricity when they were part of those projects. Now, you take someone like Anne, of course, you know, her students are in this isolated community, so that they can learn about the world, but you move Anne and her students into this whole other global environment, and they're learning with the world. Etienne Wenger is an educational theorist. Now, he talks about building global communities. And one of his principles is that you must open a dialogue between inside and outside perspectives. Now, I think Tracy did that really well with her Uganda, Canada, USA project, getting that perspective on what are the global issues here, how can we work together to solve them. So how can we do this? Well, you know, we typically say we need to start by connecting teachers. Well, this is one of the best conferences to do that. And I hope you are making vital connections, so when you go back to your school, you are starting to think of things that you could do with other schools. But then, of course, we need to look at, well, how can we connect our students? How do we bring our students into this environment where they are able to connect, learn with, etc., and collaborate? And really, it's about how we design the learning. So learning needs to be agile. It needs to be flexible. Of course, it needs to be online to do this. It needs to be collaborative and global. So build your community networks. Design collaborative learning experiences. And then amplify this by sharing with the world. So, you know, educators, we have a big responsibility here. And if you're not doing it, it's not happening. I believe every student at every grade level should have a global collaborative learning experience every year, basically. They need to be able to learn with the world, not just about the world. So thanks very much. Good luck. Stay in touch. Thank you.